maintain flight level 230.
On the departure, NASA 747A, auto 1.7 to 4000.
Researchers on the flying observatory SOFIA, the Stratospheric Observatory for Infrared Astronomy, were in the right place at the right time on October 5th when Neptune's moon Triton passed in front of a faraway star. This eclipse-like event, called an occultation, provided researchers the perfect opportunity to study Triton's atmosphere as the Neptunian moon cast a faint shadow on the Earth's surface. The team aboard the specially equipped Boeing 747 SP aircraft observed the star's light as it passed through Triton's atmosphere using the onboard telescope and instruments.
We wait for Triton to pass directly in front of a star. It takes us something like 18 months to predict when this is going to happen. And if you get very lucky, or perhaps very skilled with the pilots, you fly right through the center of the shadow. In the center of the shadow, you get a deep view of the lower atmosphere from all around the planet.
But they had to work fast. Triton's shadow raced across Earth's surface at more than 37,000 miles per hour, while the aircraft, traveling at Mach 0.83, nearly 636 miles per hour, positioned the team inside the shadow's center. Researchers, flight planners, mission directors, and pilots all worked together to get SOFIA into the shadow's center during just 2 minutes of perfect alignment.
We were trying to get within, say, 50 kilometers of the center of the shadow. In the occultation business, timing is very critical. To navigate an airplane to a particular latitude and longitude is easy enough, but getting there at, with, you know, within 30 seconds of the right time is also very, it just makes it a lot harder.
Researchers are analyzing the data from SOFIA to better study and characterize the moon's atmosphere, including its temperature, pressure, and density. They will also examine how the atmosphere varies at different altitudes to determine if it has changed since last observed.